Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 2017-2018 Spring Concert Showcase of the Mighty Black and Gold Band program. We have got an exciting evening of music and performance ahead for you. Excited to be here tonight? We're glad to have you. It's going to be a fun night. You're going to see the entire Mighty Black and Gold Band program. Before we do that, though, I do want to introduce some special guests, some folks that are extremely important to us, the support of the arts programs, in particular the music and band programs in our county. And that is some of our school board members I know that are in attendance tonight. First of all, representing our district, this is Diane Scott, District 1. Stand up and wave. Scott, thank you for all of your support. And John DeLoke, the other two in the assembly will be here. But Ms. Carol Boston, District 3. Give it up for Ms. Boston. There she is in the back there, I see her. And representing District 5, Mr. Scott Peden. Give it up for Mr. Peden as well. Of course, we appreciate all the support that we get from the county offices, and I can tell you that the fine arts are alive and well here in Santa Rosa County. Also, what we do would not be possible without the Milton High School administration. Mr. Short could not be here. His daughter is graduating college tomorrow and had an honor to serve on the night to be hooded. But Mr. Tim Short, our principal, give it up for Mr. Short. Mr. Rowell also could not be here. He had another obligation to give it up for Mr. Chad Rowell, one of our assistant principals. But we do have two assistant principals here that are both very dear and very special to me. That are very dear and very special to me. Okay? Always. Parents, you know the look, right? I love the look. All right. But are very dear and special to me, and that is Miss Amanda Letty, our assistant principal back over here. And Mr. Benji West, one of our other assistant principals right back over here. Guys, we appreciate what you do for our band program here at Milton High School on the sport. Guys, real quick, one last housekeeping item. If you have cell phones, electronic devices, please put those on mute at this time. We don't have any cell phone solos scheduled for tonight's performance, and we would appreciate if you would help us make sure that we don't have any. Also, please refrain from talking during the performances, and if you need to pass up and down the aisles and so forth, you'll do so in between the pieces. All right, ready for a great show? All right, this time I'll turn it over to our assistant director of bands. While I step backstage, get ready, give it up for Mr. Michael Schultz.
Are you ready to rock? Wow, guys, thank you. Look at all this. This is so awesome that we have this packed out for the game. So, I'm not going to talk much here. I just want to introduce the phenomenal band here, the first to start the show on the road. Please give it up for the Milton High School Pet Manor and the direction of Randy Weaver. Thank you.
Thank you. That first piece was entitled Adrenaline Engines by Mr. Randall Standridge. The next piece we're going to play for you is going to slow things down a little bit. And this piece was actually written to celebrate the beginning of a group called United Sound, which was an organization put together to put instruments in the hands of special needs students. This is entitled Risk Everything for a Dream by Richard Salcedo. And it's going to have three solos, sorry. Catch my breath here. Flute solo, we'll start with the flute solo by Miss Katie Kilgore. Then we'll have an alto saxophone solo by Miss Reagan Clark. And then we'll have a trumpet solo by Mr. Jonah Heiler. This is Risk Everything for a Dream. Speaking of best, the last selection that the Panther Band is going to play for you is a tune entitled Best of the West. And we have decided to do something a little unique with our concert bands this year, something that we haven't done, something to always push ourselves and to push our students. We're going to be playing movie music for you. We're going to do something a little different. You may have noticed this tall tower up here. Thank you, Mr. Cy Marcus, for building that for our projector. And our Professional Development Center, Mr. Mike Thorpe, and his folks, Chris Archangel, and those folks came in and put the screen up. But we're actually going to be turning the house lights or the stage lights off in just a moment, and we're going to be projecting movie scenes on the back wall, on the screen back there, and trying to play along with them. If it all lines up correctly, the music will fit the movie. That's the challenge. But we're going to conclude with a piece arranged by Michael Story. It's going to feature four different musical selections of Western movies. I Am on My Way from the musical Paint Your Wagon, The Good, the Bad, the Ugly, Blazing Saddles, and The Magnificent Seven. Here is Best of the West, arranged by Michael Story.
show what they've done this year tonight. The first one is Miss Adeline Belova. Adeline, come on out here. Hi, Adeline. I want to brag on Adeline here for just a bit. The solo she's about to play for you, she got her Straight Superiors on as solo ensemble with the help of Miss Julie Elliott here as her accompanist. She also was second chair in the Florida All-State Orchestra band this year. On top of that, she just recently auditioned, and we won't find out till this summer, she just recently auditioned for the All-National Band, so we're going to wish her luck there. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Adeline Belova.
Thank you.
Give it up one more time for Adeline Belova. The next band to perform is our second concert band, and I'm going to tell you, over the past 8 years, Mr. Schultz has done a tremendous job of this group. Please welcome to the stage the Milton High School Concert Band and their conductor, Maestro Michael Schultz.
Rhythmic watercolor, and I just want to read you a little bit little bit, but you know I'm super awkward in this, so I gotta play it. So this piece is called "Ripped with Water," colored by Brian Bogdanovich, and I want to read a little bit. Brian Bogdanovich writes, "We all share a lot of beliefs. We encourage our children to be creative, spontaneous, and we enjoy watching where their imaginations take them. The idea for this piece came from a simple set of watercolors. When children get hold of these and use their imagination, the most amazing things can happen. Children can see things that adults never see. They open our minds while we help them grow and learn. With a little imagination, these watercolors can become a magnificent sunrise or sunset over the ocean, a gorgeous view from a mountaintop, or an image of a supernova in space. The smallest drop can change the pattern and create something entirely new, either with a brush or entirely with nature. So, I encourage you, open up your mind, think of the impossible with this piece, and I hope it really moves you. So, Ripley Watercolors by Brian Bond. some beats just get you, you know? And that one definitely does. Guys, cannot say how proud I am of these cats you see on stage here. We've gone through a lot this semester, and our goal tonight is to show what we are really capable of, and I hope we are doing, I know we are doing that tonight, so good job. Mr. Weaver got us wrapped up in this has been a fun time. We are doing a piece called Robin Hood. It's from the Kevin Costner version of Robin Hood. I've almost said Men in Tights. Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves. Robin Hood, Men in Tights, make fun of this one, but that's fine. This is one of my favorite Robin Hood movies, and also this has been my favorite movie soundtrack since the movie came out, which is another Gelber form whenever that happens. So, but we've taken this, we added a little bit of video to it, and we all finally saw really what it's supposed to be. So I hope you enjoy Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves.
Thank you.
One more round of applause for Mr. Schultz and the Milton High School Concert Band. Next up, we're going to feature another soloist. This young man participated back at the Florida Band Masters District 1 Solo and Ensemble Music Performance Assessment, performing a baritone sax solo. This baritone sax solo is the only grade 7 Barry sax solo on the FBA required music list. Grade 7 being the highest caliber of music that can be performed. And he's going to do a portion of some selections from that piece tonight called Sonata for Barry Sax. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Ray Wood Miller on Barry Sax. And his accompanist, the Frank Brennan High School Band, had kids at D2 many years ago beside Lee Cook. Give it up for these guys. Thank you.
next group in line. Please welcome the Milton High School Symphonic Band under the direction of Mr. Gray Weaver.
Thank you. That first piece that we performed for you was entitled Fanfare and Flourishes by James Curnow. A very fun piece, on one I actually did back in college. And so a lot of triple tuning for our trombones and our trumpets. Some great horn riffs there for the alto saxes and the French riffs. The next piece, turn to the right page here, is a piece that is a slow ballad, beautiful piece of music that actually the students recommended for the spring concert. And it's entitled Fantasy on a Japanese folk song. I'm going to read the program notes because I think it tells it to you better than I can. It says, only in a woman's heart can there exist an inner love and an inner war simultaneously. Fantasy on a Japanese folk song tells the story of a Japanese girl who was given a music box by her mother and father when she was just a child. The music box played the Japanese goyo or child song, Suginama. As a young girl, this music box always provided a sense of comfort and solace during her trying times. When she becomes an adult, she falls in love with an American and faces a choice of either staying in her Japanese village or marrying and going back to America with him. She is so very much in love with him that she chooses to leave. However, she later realizes the need to feel close to her culture, and part of her always wonders if there was a life for her in her native Japan. As time goes by, this sense of conflict, which was more easily suppressed in the beginning, surfaces with more intensity, proving that only in a woman's heart can there exist an inner love and an inner war simultaneously. Balancing her love for her husband with her love for the culture she left behind gives way to painful episodes. During these moments, her only method of coping with her circumstances
is to lock herself away, open the music box given to her as a child, and at the sound of the very first note, begin to cry. This is Samuel Hazo's Annecy on the Japanese Folk Song.
We are going to conclude our program with our movie selection tonight. This actually is going to consist of a medley of songs from three different movies, all composed by master composer John Williams. This will conclude our part of the program. This is Soaring with John Williams, arranged by Robert W. Smith. And may the fourth be with you. Thank you.
flute solo. She's doing it unaccompanied. This is one of two solos she did at Solo Ensemble. So please give a round of applause for Miss Abigail Flores.
While they're finishing their final setup, let me make a few announcements. First of all, don't forget that our Middleton High School 24th Annual Charles Ludbell Memorial Band Banquet will take place next Saturday night on May the 12th in the Middleton High School gym. Tickets will be on sale through Monday, end of the day or end of school day on Monday. If you'd like to purchase tickets tonight following the concert, over we finish the final part of the concert in the gym, those tickets will be on sale in the lobby area. Ms. Harris and some of the boosters will be in there. Tickets are $12 each. That includes dinner.
The banquet starts at 6 o'clock next Saturday with dinner, and then awards start about 7, and awards usually end about 9 o'clock. We usually expect about 350 people at the banquet. And then once the awards end, the students will get back in. If some of the parents were staying in Cherubim, we'll have a dance till 11:30 that night. So don't forget about the MHS band banquet next Saturday night on May as well. Also, if you were not aware, a few weeks ago we had our scholarship, our band college signing night. Quite a few of our seniors received scholarship. This year we had 12 seniors that have signed to move on to the college level. So give it up for those 12 seniors. As we always tell them, we want, just like we want middle school band students to come up to high school band, we always want to push our high school students to continue playing beyond high school. We had students signed with the University of Florida. One student, we had 5 students signed with Pensacola State. We had 2 students signed with the University of South Alabama. We had 1 student signed with William Carey University. We had 3 students signed with the University of Southern Mississippi. So we're very proud about that. A few other dates that we do want you to be aware of. We'll be bringing our 8th grade band students over on Wednesday, May the 16th, what we call 8th grade band day at Hampton Park. After those activities, we'll have a better idea about next year's marching band. But next year's marching band kicks off with our step-off rehearsal on Thursday, May the 17th from 6 o'clock to 8:30. We'll have our first rehearsal getting ready for next season with the marching band. And we'll also meet the following Thursday with our downbeat rehearsal on Thursday, May the 24th, again from 6 until 8:30. So please be sure to check out charmsoffice.com. I'm getting the thumb. Awesome. I thought, okay, one joke. I had jokes ready too. You ready for a joke? All right, what did the drummer say when he got to his first gig? Would you like fries with that, sir? Ba-doosh. All right. Up next. In Northwest Florida, including the Pensacola Jazz Fest, including their own special concert at the Imogene Theater, and of course the Milton High School Band Crawfish Festival. Please give it up for Mr. Schultz and the Milton High School Blackwater Beach Jazz Band.
double.
Thank you.
Yeah, man, like the Spirit said, we have done a lot this semester. This is going to be the only time I'm going to talk right now because we're right in our two other twos. But I could not be more proud of these guys, John. We ventured out and went over to the IMUS, like Mr. Weaver said, put on a great two-hour concert over there, and man, we had a blast. If you were there, then I'm going to hear it. Thank you. Yeah, it's a great night. We're hoping to do that every year. It's such a great venue there, lots of history. But we have gone all over Milton. In fact, we played a Pensacola Jazz Fest this year as well for the first time. And so we love bringing this out, bringing this music out in the world, because we just need that. Don't we need that? Yes, absolutely. So, that first piece is obviously called Big Wig Wig Big Boy, but Wig Wig Big Boy. Oogie, Oogie, Beautiful Boy. That featured Lauren Salls, that girl trumpet. I can tell you the name of this next piece because you'll probably get it within the first beat and a half, maybe. We'll see. All right, so if you like rock and roll, you're going to love this one. This is going to feature Chandler Brown over here. Chandler, on the second one. And Luke. Alex Merritt, and you're out there. All right, and the piece after that is, this is going to be interesting. I'm just going to tell you, that's going to feature, I won't tell you it's going to feature. They'll figure it out. Okay, so, enough of me talking. I can tell a story if you want. No? All right, let's...
Thank you.
Give it up one more time. Milton High School Blackboard Miss Jeffrey. At this time, guys, we're just getting started, okay? At this time, we're going to take a 10-minute intermission. During this time, if you are standing along the walls, we're going to need you to move to empty seats. Because next up, we've got the Mighty Black and Gold Marching Band and Super Surround Sound. So 10 minutes, right back here, the drums and your city. Thank you.
Is the band ready to perform? And now, we proudly present the Milton High School Marching Band, the Mighty Black and Gold!
As children, we dreamed of touching the sky and sailing through the clouds. With courage and hope, we press upward and onward into the vast unknown ocean of stars.
Thank you.
And now, Panther fans, before we conclude this portion of the concert, we wanted to take you back to Friday nights at Panther Stadium, one of our new, most popular stand favorites. Introduced to us last summer by new head coach, football coach, Harry Lees, here is our version of Ball and Parlay.
All right, my thank you, Dan. Let's show them what we do. We'll be right back.
celebration of John Wayne and Channel 37. Give it up for Black Belt Drummer!
I really appreciate it. I really appreciate everyone coming over here and letting us show off our final three groups. They've worked just as hard as everyone else. And hello. Is that not there? and they're gonna. Oh, they're doing their chant. It's awesome. I've never started it before. Okay. All right. anyway, the first group you're going to see tonight is our JV Winter Guard. Ladies in red over here. They've had a busy season, just like the other groups going around, competing on the Gulf Coast Color Guard and percussion circuits. When it was all said and done, they finished third in their class. So give it up for them. Both our color guards are under the direction of Miss Samantha Bird, right over here. And the color guard tech, Brittany Wilson, helping them out. So, without further ado, give it up for the JV, Milton High School JV Winter Guard.
kiss me.
Floor change here, and then we're gonna get to our varsity fun. Hang on, varsity. Varsity winter guard participated in the Gulf Coast Guard and Percussion Circuit throughout the semester. Also competing in a different class. By the end of the season, they ended up finishing sixth in their class. So very proud of them. Please give it up for the Milton High School Varsity Winter Guard.
May 26, 2003, Aaron Ralston was hiking. A boulder fell on his right hand. He waited 4 days, then amputated his arm with a pocket knife. On New Year's Eve, a woman was bungee jumping in Zimbabwe. The cord broke. She then fell into a river and had to swim back to land in crocodile-infested waters with a broken collarbone. Claire Champlin was smashed in the face by a 5-pound watermelon being propelled by a slingshot. Matthew Brobst was hit by a javelin. David Striegel was punched in the face by a kangaroo. The most amazing part about these stories is when asked about the experience, they all smiled, shrugged, and said, "I guess things could have been worse." Tell me about the traffic. Tell me about your boss. Tell me about the job that you've been trying to quit for the past 4 years. She didn't speak for 48 hours. When my uncle was murdered, we had to send out a search party to find my father's voice. Most people have no idea that tragedy and silence have the exact same address. When your day is a museum of disappointments hanging from events that were outside of your control, when you find yourself flailing in an ocean of why is this happening to me, when it feels like your guardian angel put in his 2-week notice 2 months ago and just decided not to tell you. When it feels like God is just a babysitter that's always on the phone. When you get punched in the esophagus by a fistful of life. Remember that every year, 2 million people die of dehydration. So it doesn't matter if the glass is half full or half empty. There's water in the cup. Drink it. And stop complaining. Muscle is created by repeatedly lifting things that have been designed to weigh us down. So when your shoulders feel heavy, stand up straight and lift your chin. Call it exercise. When the world crumbles around you, you have to look at that wreckage and then build a new one out of the pieces that are still here. Remember, you are still here.
Act like it. All right. Our final group in performance tonight is the Black Gold Percussion Ensemble. They were also on the GCPPGPC circuit this spring. They ended up, you see those medals around their neck? Well, that's because they ended the season earning second place in their class. They are under the direction of that busy guy right there, Mr. John Whitten, our percussion director. With help from percussion tech Chandler Sedlacek. Wherever he is. Right there? There you are. Please welcome the Milton High School Black Gold Percussion Ensemble.
Initiating system startup.
A breach in the firewall
has been detected. System shutdown is imminent.
This question, have you got your money's worth tonight? Ladies and gentlemen, that is our final public performance for the 2017-18 year. The next performance will feature the 2018-19 Mighty Black and Gold Band on Thursday, July the 26th at 7 p.m. as they reveal their new halftime show, The Courage Within. So be sure to join us on Thursday, July the 26th for our next public performance. Now, we are very proud to be in a school that is steeped in 102 years of tradition. And so it would only be appropriate that we always conclude our concert with the Milton High School alma mater. If you are an alumni of Milton High School, please stand. Something special we do, we ask our seniors. We have 41 seniors. We ask them to come forward, and this will be the first time that they don't play the alma mater of the band. So again, thank you for your participation. Let me remind you that band banquet tickets are on sale through Monday. You can purchase them tonight when we get done right outside the concession counter in the front of the gym right here. Here we are, Mighty Black and Gold Band with a Milton High School alma mater.
Thank you very much. Have a pleasant evening.